advice to you will be very, very simple. Because you are about to embark on a massive change. For the upper six, this is your year. 2022 is your year. You will leave home for the first time. You will live with other people that are not your parents for the first time. You will do your A-levels and get your results. You will start your degree. You will move to a new place and start a new adventure. Those are big things. This is your year, and you need to make the very most of it that you possibly can. Massive change. I've got big changes coming up this year as well. And I've seen loads of changes happen here at Stafford Grammar School. When I came here in 2008, which was the same day as Mr. Anderson, I can see him standing there. I was a very strict teacher. I was not like the teddy bear and the pushover that I am today. I was completely different. But it's the kids at Stafford Grammar that sort of melted me down a bit and changed my outlook. And I have to say, as you in year 11 go off to do your exams, and sixth form you go off to do your exams, and you move away to exciting new things, I am genuinely really, really proud of all of you. Because not just the academic stuff that you've done and the extracurricular things or all the music and the plays and the sports and everything else, that's brilliant. But I'm actually really proud of you because of the kinds of people that you've become and that you are becoming. So what can I offer to you as you go on new adventures? Well, the first thing I would say is own your own successes and failures. Whether that's in your exams, in your career, in your life, own your own successes and failures, because they don't belong to anybody else. How you do, whether it's in the exams, whether it's in a job interview, whether it's in whatever you want to pursue, is entirely down to you. I've had lots of successes and I've had lots of failures as well, and we don't talk about the failures bit, but I'm equally responsible for both. And you are responsible for both the successes and the failures. Okay, so that's the first thing. The second thing that I would say to you, when you decide what you want to do, what you want to be, and what you want to become, enjoy the journey of getting there as much as you celebrate the destination when you do. Because the journey getting there is the exciting part. It was only a year or so into me starting teaching that I decided I wanted to become a head teacher. But the getting there, and the climbing, and the challenges, and the opportunities, and the things to do, that was the exciting part. And if you're not careful, you'll miss all of the fun bits on the journey. And I made that mistake. Make sure that you enjoy all of the steps on the journey, and all of the things that come your way, so that you make the most of every day. And the third and final thing that I will offer to you is make sure that you keep first things first. We talk about our values in school all the time. You, when you leave here, I hope, are leaving with far more than a set of qualifications and some certificates. What I want you to leave here with is a set of values that you will carry with you, that you will stick to your values in whatever you do and whatever situations you face in your life and in your future. The other thing to make sure you do as you keep first things first, make sure that you invest in the things that really, really matter. Your family, your friends, your relationships. Because when the journey's finished, you won't wish that done a little bit more work. You won't wish that you'd done a few extra hours. You'll wish that you'd invested in those things that really matter and enrich you and enrich your life. So keep those things first all the time. I can't remember which tennis player it was, but he was asked, what do you wish you knew when you were 16 that you know now? And he said, what I wish I'd known when I was 16 that I know now is when you get to the top, there's nothing there. It's the experiences and the relationships and the way that we interact. act and the way that we treat people and the person that we're becoming through the experiences that we have, that will enrich us and that will make our lives mean something. And that's what I want for you. I want your lives to mean something. Your life has to mean something. So make sure that it does. And even on the days in school when we've been having a go at you, or we've been grumpy with you, or we've shouted at you, or we've given you detention, or whatever it is, the reason behind that, even though you didn't like it, was because we want your life to mean something. And that you grow up as an example of what a good, full, and abundant life is all about. That's my final word to you. Year 11, upper 6, you'll never have to listen to me in an assembly ever again. But whatever you go on to do in your exams, in year 11, in the sixth form year, and the rest of your school career, make it matter, enjoy every moment of it, and take from it things that are going to enrich you